Hi friends, in this video we are going to see how Phasor diagram is an important tool while calculation of all AC voltage waveforms, addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. So let's see what the Phasor diagram is. The diagram in which different alternating quantities of the same frequency, sinusoidal in nature, are represented by individual phasors indicating exact phase interrelationships is known as Phasor diagram. So what if I have all the quantities can be shown on the same diagram? But for that to achieve, one important point is it should have same frequency. So it's very important so that we can avoid drawing waveforms, writing equations, and calculation will become very easy. So here I have considered three cases and I have considered only two quantities. Actually the quantities could be more than two. It could be current, voltage, power, flux. So whenever quantities are in phase, the phase relationship is like this. This voltage and this current are in phase. See, the equation will be V equal to Vm sin theta and I equal to Im sin theta. In both the ways, angle phi is 0. So V will be represented like this, I is also represented like this. So if I see interrelationship of phase between these two, it will be like this. I and V are in phase. So whenever the quantities are in phase, that means the phase difference between them is 0. Second case, lagging phase. So for lagging phase, the phasor diagram will be like this. So I consider V like this and I like this. So the equation of I will be Im sin theta, because the phase angle for this I is 0, therefore it is along positive x axis direction. But for this V, it is V equal to Vm sin theta plus 90. So it's a plus 90, that means angle made by this quantity with a positive x axis direction is 90. Whenever I see these two waveforms or these two phasors on same diagram, this phasor diagram I will get, and I can say this I lagging this V by angle 90 degree, because in a phasor diagram this I is behind this V. Same way for a leading phase, I can say this is a voltage and this is a current. So in this way I can say here voltage is behind current. So I can say voltage lags current by 90 degree, or suppose I want to say in terms of current, current leads voltage by 90 degree. Same is the case for this also. Either I can say current lags voltage by 90 degree or voltage leads current by 90 degree. So in all these three cases, what we have seen is two quantities we have represented simultaneously. This is possible only if the frequency is same. So in the first case, the phase angle for both the quantities are 0. So therefore, V and I are in phase. In second case, the phase difference is 90 degree. But it is 90 degree such a way that one quantity is behind other quantity. So here, I is behind I. So I can say in anticlockwise sense, voltage leads current by 90 degree or current lags voltage by 90 degree. Same is the case for the third, that is leading phase. Current leads voltage by 90 degree, or in other way I can say voltage lags current by 90 degree. So here I have just shown two quantities and explained the concept of phasor diagram. Actually it could be more than two, and phasor diagram advantage is that all the quantities having same frequency can be represented in same diagram, and interrelationship of phase we can calculate very easily. Now let's go to the next point, where some important aspects regarding Phasor diagram we can see. The first point is, generally reference phasor chosen is shown along the positive x-axis. Most of the cases, whenever we start drawing a phasor diagram, we need to choose a reference phasor. So reference phasor normally we take as a positive x-axis. So the quantity which are along the positive x-axis, we take that as a phasor, which we call as a reference phasor. Second, there may be more than two quantities, example voltage, current, flux, represented in phasor diagram. But the important point is the frequency of all of them must be the same. Phasor diagrams of the same frequency quantities can be drawn. If the frequencies are different, we cannot show those quantities in the same phasor diagram. Third, the phasors which are ahead in anticlockwise direction with respect to reference phasor are said to be leading, and phasors behind the reference are said to be lagging. That we have seen just now. So in one case, the V was ahead of a reference, so we say V leading. In other case, we have seen the voltage was behind the phasor, so we say voltage lags. So all these are related to each other. If I consider out of the two phasors, one as a reference, obviously the other phasor, either it will be a lagging or it will be leading. When it will be lagging? When that phasor is behind the reference. And when it will be leading? When the phasor under consideration is ahead of a reference, then we can say that phasor is leading. Thank you.